So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB 247. So guys, Friday ko aap logo ka session nahi ho paya tha due to certain technical reasons, but don't worry, everything will be covered through the upcoming sessions, right? In today's session, we are going to talk about the PIB news from 27th to 28th September. I know thoda sa delay hai do din ka, but don't worry, everything will be covered. It is my duty and I will do that, all right? So let's begin with the session, guys, without any delay. But before we begin, if you want to have the PDF of this session, you can join the Telegram channel, and the link for which is provided in the description. All right. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, consider the following statements with respect to Jaldoot app and you have to identify the correct statement. Now, we have recently discussed, I believe in the previous class, we have talked about this Jaldoot app, but we are talking about it again because there are some more information about this app, right? So let's talk about the information which have been provided by the government, and then let's come back to the question. All right, so remember, as we have discussed already, that the Ministry of Rural Development has launched this Jaldoot app. Now, what is the objective of this app? Remember, it has been launched to capture the water level of selected 2-3 wells in a village. So in a village, they will select 2 or 3 wells and they will check the water level of that of those wells, right? Now, this will obviously give the information about the level of groundwater in these villages, right? This app has been developed by the joint efforts of Ministry of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj. And remember, the very interesting thing that the officers which will be assigned to measure the water levels will be known as Jaldoots, right? They will be called as what? Jaldoots. Now, these Jaldoots, the officers, will have to upload the geotagged photographs through the app on every occasion of measurement. On every occasion of measurement, they have to upload the geotagged photographs to prove that they have done their job, right? This mobile app will work in both online and offline mode. This is something very interesting. Online or offline mode, dono mein kaam karega ye. And the data, whatever data the Jaldoots will upload, that data will be integrated with the National Water Informatics Center. All right, so that's all about this app. And now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. So the app has been developed by Ministry of Jal Shakti. Is that so? No. It has been developed by Ministry of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj. Right. So this statement is incorrect. The officers assigned to measure the water levels will be known as Jaldoots. This is absolutely correct. And this app will work in both online and offline mode. So I don't see any problem with this third statement as well. So therefore, the correct answer will be what, guys? Option B, only 2 and 3. Alright, let's talk about question number 2 then. Union Cabinet has approved the extension of Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana. The scheme has been extended from October 2022 to which month or year? Remember, it has been again extended, right? On 30th September 2022. On 30th September 2022, its phase 6 ended, right? The phase 6 of this Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana ended on 30th September 2022, and now the Union Cabinet has approved the extension of this scheme from October 2022 to December 2022. And of course, this will be the 7th phase of this scheme, right? I hope you all know this, that this scheme was launched during the COVID-19 pandemic, and abhi tak isko Bharat Sarkar ne continue kiya hai. In the 7th phase, ₹44,762 will be used, and it has been allocated by the Government of India. And of course, under the scheme, 5 kg of food grain per person per month is provided free of cost to all the beneficiaries under the National Food Security Act of 2013. Alright. So if I talk about this question, the correct answer will be December 2022. Option B will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 3. With which country's embassy, Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, which in short is DPIIT, has signed a joint statement to formalize the bilateral fast track mechanism. Now, first of all, what is this bilateral fast track mechanism? Iski baat kar lete hain, then I'll come to the question. Remember, this platform, this bilateral fast track mechanism platform, it will serve as a platform for faster resolution of investment cases of Dutch companies operating in India. Now, you have heard this name, Dutch companies. The correct answer will be what? Netherlands, right? Netherlands ko hi Dutch bhi bola jata hai. So this platform will, resolve the investment cases of Dutch companies which are operating in India, right? And for this, DPIIT has signed this joint statement with Embassy of Netherlands, which is operating in India, right? And remember, very important information is that Invest India, which is a national investment promotion and facilitation agency, is the executing body of this bilateral fast track mechanism between India and Netherlands, right? And this mechanism will strengthen and assist bilateral efforts to increase mutual investment activities as well as support and develop business cooperation between companies in both the countries, right? So this is just for the basic, you know, information. The three most important things are these. DPIIT and Embassy of Netherlands have signed the joint statement to formalize the bilateral fast track mechanism. This will be executed by Invest India, which is the National Investment Promotion and Facilitation Agency. And of course, this platform will work towards faster resolution of investment cases of Dutch companies which are operating in India. All right. So the correct answer is what, guys? Option D, Netherlands. Moving ahead to question number 4. Which of the following organizations has convened the Mondia Cult Conference 2022? Now, this is something interesting because the Mondia Cult Conference ज़्यादातर news में नहीं रहता है, but this time it is in news because this is the third such conference which has been organized by UNESCO. Right, so UNESCO World Conference on Cultural Policies and Sustainable Development, which is also known as what? Mondia Cult, right? And for the year 2022, it has been organized by UNESCO, right? And this has been organized to shape a resilient cultural sector with an objective of achieving sustainable development goals, basically to develop the cultural sector and tourism sector, basically most importantly the cultural sector. So to develop the cultural sector with the ultimate objective of achieving the sustainable development goal, right? This is the third such conference. The very first conference took place in 1982 in Mexico City. Second one took place in 1998 in Stockholm. So after a long gap of around 22 and 24 years, it is being held in the year 2022 by UNESCO, right? And Minister of State for Culture, Mr. Arjun Ram Meghwal, represented India at the conference. More than this, nothing is important regarding this conference, not at all required, right? Agar exam mein question aayega to yahi hoga ki Mondiacal conference kisne organize kara tha. The correct answer will be UNESCO, option A. Moving ahead to question number 5. Which ministry has launched a month-long nationwide Clean India 2.0 campaign from 1st to 31st October 2022? This campaign, this is the second edition. The first edition was launched last year by Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sport, headed by Anurag Singh Thakur. Youth Affairs and Sports, right? It is headed by Mr. Anurag Singh Thakur. Now, of course, the second edition has been launched by the Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sport, right? Now, what is the objective? The objective of this campaign is to focus on collection of waste and disposing it off. Waste ko collect karna, usko dispose karna, and this waste can be of any kind, like e-waste, right? Plastic waste, paper waste, any kind of waste will be collected under this campaign, and all the waste will be disposed of, right? This program is being organized in all the villages across the country. And it will be implemented through the network of Nehru Yuva Kendra Sangathan, affiliated youth clubs and National Service Scheme, NSS, right? And the target is to collect 1 crore kg of waste from the environment, all right? And as I told you already, the correct answer is option C. Moving ahead to question number 6. Minister of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Mr. Bhupendra Yadav, has attended the World Green Economy Summit 2022. Where did it take place? Remember, it took place in Dubai, UAE. Option A is the correct answer. And there is no need to go into the details. Not at all required. Which ministry has organized Swachh Shahar Samvad and technology exhibition to showcase model ideas in waste management? Wherever you see this word, Swachh Shahar, right? The correct answer will be what? Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. There is no doubt in this. And this ministry is headed by Mr. Hardeep Singh Puri. And he's also the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. All right. A tripartite MOU, or you can say a three-party MOU, has been signed amongst Department of Empowerment of Persons with Disabilities, Sector Skill Council for Persons and Disabilities, and an e-commerce company. Which of the following is the e-commerce company? Remember, this MOU has been signed to impart skill to the person with disabilities, right? That is the objective, and this has been signed with the e-commerce giant Amazon. Option A is the correct answer. How much amount has been allocated by the Government of India for the creation of National Research Foundation? It was there in one of the PIB releases. That entire PIB release is not important, but from that, this information is very, very important. So for creation of National Research Foundation, rupees 5,000 crore has been allocated by the Government of India. Option D is the correct answer, guys. National SC-ST Hub Conclave has been organized in Ahmedabad to spread awareness about the National SC-ST Hub Scheme. Which ministry has organized the conclave? Remember, this scheme is being implemented by Ministry of MSME headed by Narayan Rane to inculcate the entrepreneurship capabilities, among SC and ST youths, right? And remember, the nodal agency to implement this scheme is NSIC, which is National Small Industries Corporation, which works under the Ministry of MSME, right? And therefore, the correct answer is option B, Ministry of MSME. Name the campaign organized by Ministry of Science and Technology headed by Dr. Jitendra Singh. Dr. Jitendra Singh is the minister to showcase the technological breakthroughs and innovation in each of the 37 CSIR laboratories institutes spread across the country. So you just have to name this campaign, and the objective is to showcase the technological breakthroughs and innovation which have taken place in all the laboratories and institutes of CSIR. Right, the correct answer is 1 week, 1 lab, option A. Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers, headed by Mansukh Mandavia, who is also the Minister of Health and Family Welfare, has given away the 11th National Petrochemical Awards. Who among the following has been awarded with Lifetime Recognition Award in the field of chemicals and petrochemicals? Now, there were various categories of awards in which there were various awardees. But various awardees may say, of course, they are not going to ask anything. In the lifetime recognition, there was only one awardee, and that was Mr. Rajnikant Shroff. And that is why this question is here. Option D is the correct answer. With which IIT, Center for Development of Telematics, this is OFF, has signed an MOU for cooperation in various areas of telecom? Very direct question. This IIT in question is IIT Delhi. Option B is the correct answer. And the last question for today. Department of Food and Public Distribution has organized workshops to popularize and create awareness about the benefits of fortified rice. It's something incorrect here. Benefits of fortified rice in tribal belts of the country. The workshops have been organized in 8 states in collaboration with the respective state governments. Which of the following is not among the 8 states? So these are the 8 states, guys, where this, these workshops have been organized. So these are Gujarat, Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, Telangana, Rajasthan and Kerala. So the state which is not among the 8 states is Odisha. Option E is the correct answer. All right. And that's it for today's session, guys. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section, and I will see you in the next session on Wednesday with the news from 28th, 29th and 30th of September. All right. So thank you so much for watching, guys. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.